Is your first name Alex?
Yes.
Did you ever leave the scene of an auto accident that you caused?
No.
Did you ever spy on your wife's emails?
No.
Have you answered the truth to the questions?
How did I end up in a New York prison answering questions about my personal life? Well, this guy said I'd never beat him in a lie detector test, and that was a red rag to a bull. I had to prove him wrong. His name is Ed Torian, and he's an expert polygraph operator with over 30 years' experience at spotting a liar.
What do you think makes the polygraph so successful?
There's no way you can overcome it.
There's no way. Maybe I should stop now. Maybe I shouldn't bother with this challenge. But can somebody train themselves to do this? Can somebody sort of just be calm at all times?
Just by being calm is not going to overcome the polygraph test.
Why would that not work?
Well, because if you're too calm and you don't show any reaction, it's just going to show on the polygraph chart is a flat tracing.
Oh, I see. Okay, so if you see a flat tracing, you know that someone's hiding something.
Well, it's like if they took a sedative.
It sounds like a very, very difficult machine to fool. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go away, do a bit of research, find out how they work, and I'll just try and tell a barefaced lie and see if I get away with it.
Okay, good luck.
Ed was adamant that his machine could not be beaten. But then, I've always liked the challenge.
Do you think someone can get a lie past a polygraph machine?
Not past me.
I get to set the challenge, and I'm determined to do all I can by fair means or foul to give me the best chance of victory. I'll turn to science, technology, and my old hustle skills to get an edge. So the first thing is to find out exactly how the machines work. Doug Williams was formerly a detective sergeant for the Oklahoma City Police and was in charge of lie detection for their internal affairs department. Like Ed, Doug's conducted thousands of lie detector tests, but he's not so sure about their reliability. He's concerned about the way the machines measure the minute bodily responses associated with lying.
Alexis?
And I want to find out if this perceived flaw was something I could exploit.
Doug, tell me a little bit more about what this actually measures and what you can actually see.
See this tracing here? That's your heartbeat. Every time your heartbeat moves up and down.
The two black ones on the top?
This is your stomach breathing and this is your chest breathing. That's your sweat activity in your hand, and this is the motion sensor pad.
So you've been giving this test, I mean, you've done it thousands of times for pretty serious situations.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
So what made you change?
In order for the polygraph to be valid as a lie detector, one thing must be true. That is that this reaction that they say indicates deception must always only indicate deception. While it's true that when your heart starts to beat fast, your breathing becomes erratic, your blood pressure increases, your sweat activity increases, you're having that response evoked by the act of lying. Any number of innocent stimuli can cause the exact same reaction that would be branded as a lie.
So although polygraphs measure physiological changes when we lie, some changes occur for other reasons. I smell an opportunity. So I asked Doug to hook me up to the machine so I could see exactly what it monitors.
Get the show on the road here.
Doug got me to relax so he could show me what the machine measured for my normal state.
Think about the beach.
Before asking me to think of something which scared me to illustrate how fear was measured on the machine.
Think about falling.
Now, I'm terrified of heights, but sitting in the comfort of an office block, I had to really focus before I felt any different. But had the machine picked up on this?
Okay, now to review. Nice and calm and even, just totally relaxed, like the waves of the ocean, which you were visualizing. Then we come along here to the control, which they do by way of comparison. I said, think about falling. That was not a pleasant thought for you.
No.
See how the GSR just peaked completely off the chart?
That's my sweat response.
That's your sweat activity. Boom, like that, immediately. And then we have the erratic breathing pattern, increase in blood pressure, and all that.
Even though I wasn't aware of a big change, the machine had picked up subtle changes in my heart rate, breathing, and sweat levels. So if situations other than lying can change the reading, that's something I could use to my advantage. If I could find a reliable way of controlling my emotions, maybe that could help me outwit Ed Torian and his machine. So I went to meet up with a guy to help me do just that.